Hi guys, I know it's been a while since I've done one of these, but I just wanted to go over some of our recent N-scale and HO-scale releases, starting obviously with our F units here. These are freight F3s. We've released three different paint schemes, Union Pacific, Southern Pacific, and CB&Q, as you can see. The Southern Pacific and CB&Q units have just shipped out to hobby stores. The Union Pacific units shipped just this past March, but they are all available in stores right now, and I just wanted to kind of go over the different releases and just kind of give you a look at them. We'll start, because why not, with the Union Pacific. Good old Union Pacific. There's not a lot to say about this. It's a freight F3. These were probably originally purchased by the UP to be used in their streamliner services, but as the UP transitioned to using the larger E units, they refitted these with freight pilots and put them into freight service. So we have both A units and B units, as you can see. The gray ends. Next, we'll move on to the Southern Pacific, the Black Widow units. There's a variety of different SP paint schemes, the Black Widow, the Bloody Nose. This is one of my personal favorites. It's got a really classy kind of look to it. But these were freight units, although they do resemble some of the passenger units that they'd use on like their business trains, their excursion trains and stuff. So. We came out with these the first time, I believe, in 2007. We sold out of them pretty quickly, so it was a nice opportunity for those of you who may have missed them the first time to pick up these nice looking. This one's a little more boring, but nothing's perfect. F units. Lastly, we have a new scheme that we've not done before, at least not on these particular locomotives. And these are the CB&Q freight units. This is a similar paint scheme to what we did on the F2s not too long ago. These are, of course, F3s. You'll notice that they have the straight passenger pilot. These were units that were originally used on like the Zephyr service, but again, eventually they got repurposed. They got repainted, they painted over that stainless steel and put them into freight use. And there's the B unit, for good measure. Nice classy Burlington lettering and striping. New in HO these past few months, we have HO GP35s in Santa Fe and New York Central. They're coming in two different road numbers each. This locomotive was one that we did last in 1999, so it's been a long time coming, so to speak. These are new paint schemes that we didn't do back then, so it's an ideal way for modelers to either pick up something that they missed out on in the past, or, you know, add something new to their collection. Starting off with the New York Central GP35, this is a Phase 1A locomotive. You can tell by all the little latches along here, it's kind of the primary difference between the 1As and the 1Bs. So this is a Phase 1A, so is the Santa Fe. No dynamic brake up there. One update for this run of the GP35s is the original run did not have separately molded windshield wipers, so that is a new feature for this release, which is a nice touch. But there you go, yeah. Classic black New York Central. Moving on then, we have the Santa Fe with the dynamic brake hatch, as is appropriate. Again, you see those molded on, not those molded on, those separately molded windshield wipers there. A new feature for this release. This is the classic pinstripe freight scheme. really nice models, really solid mechanism. It's one that, again, we haven't done for about 15 years, so, well, more than that, really. So it's nice to be able to bring this back and make it available to modelers again. One last thing I wanted to share with you guys, because it is something new that we're taking orders for right now. These are custom painted HO GP35s. These are part of the Kato Kobo line, similar to other projects we've done in the past. One exception is that these are being sold exclusively through the Kato USA online store. So these are only available ordered directly from Kato USA. Here we have the Montana Rail Link custom painted unit. This is completely painted, and even down to the handrails. You can see here you've got the white safety railing. This is a special feature of the custom painted units. They have a little more detail than the base ones that we get from our factory do. But you can see custom painted and lettered in that Montana railing scheme. This is an early kind of a quick sample that the gentleman in Japan put together for us. So the final one will be a little cleaner, a little less rushed, but you can see he's adjusted the horn so it's in the rearward position, which is appropriate for the Montana Rail Link locomotives. And you can see there just all the custom numbering and lettering he put on it. Moving on, we have Mopac. Missouri Pacific. Very nice looking Screaming Eagle scheme there. Unit 606. This one has the non-dynamic brake catch. Again, painted railings. Last but not least, we have Chicago and Eastern Indiana, C&EI. That same Mopac Screamin' Eagle scheme. This one has the dynamic brake hatch on there and the road number, which I'm sure someone thought was hilarious when they picked it. Yeah, these are all custom painted units. These are all available from the Kato USA online store. I'll provide a link in the description for this video. And yeah, we are currently taking orders for delivery towards the end of July, early August. So if you like what you see, head on over to the site. There's a lot more photos, so check it out.